This video is going to provide an overview of Windows 10. Windows 10 is the new operating system being installed on many PCs across campus. There will be some differences between Windows 10 and Windows 7, the previous operating system that has been in use across campus. One of the major differences you're going to notice is the Start menu. When you first click on the Start menu, you'll see that the look has changed dramatically. There are now tiles. There is still a list of applications that you can use and find by scrolling through. And you also have another menu here on the left that can be expanded by clicking on the three bars. This is the way that you will log off of the computer when you are done, clicking on your profile name and then clicking on the sign out button. You can also access your File Explorer as well as settings from this menu. Your settings will allow you to adjust certain things on your Windows 10 operating system. Most of what you're going to be able to adjust is in the personalization area. This can allow you to change your background, adjust the look of your Start menu to a certain degree, and even change various settings on your taskbar, which is the bar here at the bottom. There's some simple ways to change your Start menu. All of the tiles that you see here can be removed, and you can add additional tiles if you want to make other applications more easily accessible. I'm going to go ahead and right-click on one of these tiles, and you'll see that there's an option to unpin it from your Start menu. This is how you will remove tiles from this part of your screen. Once we right-click and unpin them, they are removed. I'll go ahead and remove all of these items to show you how you can create new groups and add your own tiles to the Start menu. So now we have a blank slate. And if we want to create a new group of items that we're going to be able to access quickly, we can do that in two ways. We can right-click on an item and pin it to the Start menu, or we can find our item and we can drag it and drop it to the menu. Now that we've got our items in a group, we can name this group. If we want to create other groups, we simply drag our items and create the groups as needed. We'll call this group Office. There is another way that you can make items easily accessible for yourself. You can pin those items to your taskbar if you would like even quicker access. This means you won't even have to open up your Start menu to find these items. So let's find another item here that we use a lot. And what we want to do is click on the item and drag it down to the taskbar in order to create a link for that item. Once we have a link down there on the taskbar, we can access it anytime we need simply by clicking on that icon. One final place we can add shortcuts to applications is on our desktop. Once we have an item that we want to make available on the desktop, we can click on that item and drag it to our desktop in order to make a shortcut. The next thing I want to discuss is how we access the internet on Windows 10. We still utilize what's known as a web browser. However, the web browser that Microsoft now offers as their default browser is a little bit different. If we click on the E, instead of opening Internet Explorer, it's going to open what's called Microsoft Edge. Microsoft Edge still functions like a web browser, but there are some differences, and some of your websites may not work perfectly with Microsoft's new web browser Edge. However, you can use it, and it does work for the most part. If you want to use Microsoft's older web browser, known as Internet Explorer, you'll need to click on the search box here and then start to type Internet Explorer. Once you find it, you can go ahead and click on it to open. And if you want to make sure you have easy access to it moving forward, we can right-click on it and then pin it to our taskbar. That way it'll be there for us anytime we need it. This is going to be a familiar browser for anyone that's used it in the past. And you really shouldn't see any difference between this version of Internet Explorer and what you've been using before. In order to access Google Chrome, which is another web browser that we recommend in the IT department, click on your start menu and scroll down to find Google Chrome. Once you find it, you can create a shortcut on your desktop, and you can pin it to your start menu, or you can even create a pin on your taskbar. So now you'll have options to access Chrome anytime you need it. We'll just move this to our office group for now. Now that we have access to Google Chrome, we can log in and do things like check our email, access my Brevard, or any other web-based tools that we need to utilize when we're using Windows 10. We do recommend using Google Chrome to access your email, as you will notice that there is no more mail icon on your desktop. The best way to access your email in Windows 10 is to open Google Chrome, get to a fresh tab, and go to mail.brevard.edu. Once you're there, you simply type in your full email address and your password on the next screen in order to access your Brevard College email. If anyone has questions about utilizing Windows 10, please reach out to the IT department as well, and we'll be happy to address specific questions for anyone that has them.